Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I'm talking about distance, rate, and time problems today. Whenever you're doing a travel problem, you're flying, you're walking, you're biking, you're running, you're on a boat, those are all, we use the distance, rate, and time formula. I call it the DIRT formula, D equals RT, so you can remember when you're traveling over the dirt. You know that formula if you wanted to know how far have you traveled in your car, and you knew that you were going 50 miles an hour for 3 hours, you'd say 50 times 3, and you'd know you'd gone 150 miles, right? So that's the basic formula that we're going to use. Tristan drove for 4 hours on the freeway. He then decreased his speed by 20 miles per hour and drove for 5 more hours. What I left off here was like on a country road or something. And then his total distance was 512 miles. What was his speed on the freeway? So I hope you can agree with me that his distance on the freeway plus his distance on the dirt road or road was a total of 512 miles. So what I'm going to do is say, well, what was his rate on the freeway? I'm calling that F. On the freeway, his rate was, that's an X. I wrote it funny because I was writing over something. He was going X miles per hour. When he got to the road, he was going X miles per hour minus 20 because he decreased his speed by 20. So instead of distance, I'm going to call this rate and time. On the freeway, he was driving 4 hours at a speed of X. I don't know what that was. On the dirt road, he drove for 5 more hours, and his speed was X minus 20. This is the distance of the freeway driving, 4 times X. This is the distance of the dirt road driving, and if we add those together, that equals 512. If I distribute that, I get 5x minus 100. 5x and 4x is 9x, and I'm going to add 100 to both sides, and I get 612, and I'm going to divide both sides by 9. And 612 divided by 9 is 68. So his X speed was 68. What is X? Is 68 something to do with his freeway or the road driving? Well, we said X was going to be his freeway speed in miles per hour. So he was going 68 miles per hour on the freeway. And if I wanted to know how fast he went on the road, we would just subtract 20 and we'd say he was going 48 miles per hour when he was on the regular road. Okay, next problem, we have three of them here. The next one, Kira runs 6 miles in 1.1 hours. She runs at speeds of 5 miles per hour and 6 miles per hour. How long did she run at each speed? Well, we know she didn't run at 6 miles per hour the whole time, or else she would have finished in exactly 1 hour, right? She had some time at 5 and sometimes at 6. This is a little trickier, but I think we can agree that her distance at 5 miles per hour plus her distance at 6 miles per hour adds up to 6 miles. That's how far she ran altogether. Sometimes she was running at 5, sometimes she was running at 6. And instead of distance, we're going to do rate times time. Well, what was her rate when she was running at 5 miles per hour, and what was her rate she was running at 6 miles per hour? Well, we just said it, right? We know 5 and 6 were her rates then. Well, how much time was she running there? Remember, distance is equal to rate times time. We know her rate. It says it right there. We want to know how much time. Well, all I know is that she spent 1.1 hours altogether. So let's say that she was running at 5 miles per hour for X minutes. Or I think we probably talk about it as X hours, which will be some fraction of an hour, right? But everything else is in hours. How long did she run it at 6 miles per hour? And this is a tricky little thing that you have to get down. If I told you that she ran, let's say, for 4 hours and 1 hour was at 5 miles per hour, you could tell me, well, then she must have run for the other rest of those hours at 6 miles per hour, right? If you know, okay, let's say she ran for 10 hours, and I told you that she did 2 hours here. then you'd say, oh, then she must have run for 8 hours at the other one. All you would do is subtract what you know to see what's left, okay? Well, that's what we have here. We know how long she ran altogether. We're going to subtract how long she ran at 5 miles per hour, and what we're going to be left with is how long she ran at 6 miles per hour. So this is a little trick where you take the total amount and you subtract off one thing, and you have to be left with the other. This is something that you have to get down. If I told you I got some A's and some B's and I had 5 grades, and then I told you, well, I had 2 A's, you would automatically say, oh, then you had 3 B's, because you would take the 2 that you know and you would subtract it from the total. And that's what we're doing here. We're taking the X that we know, we don't really know it, but we're calling it X, and we're subtracting it from the total and saying what's left is going to be the minutes at 6 miles per hour. All right, or the time, hours at 6 miles per hour. Okay, so for the distance times time, rate times time, I'm sorry, for this is 5 times X. And for the 6 times, she went 6 was her rate, and her time was 1.1 minus X. And now I'm going to distribute that over there and get 6.6 minus 6X. 5X minus 6X is negative X. And if I subtract 6.6 from both sides, this was supposed to be 6.0, sorry. If I subtract 6.6, I get negative, right? Which makes sense because I have a negative on the other side. 6 minus 6.6 is negative 0.6. And then if I divide both sides by negative 1, I get X equals 0.6. So what that tells me is that we said X was going to be how long she was running at 5 miles per hour. So she, 5 miles per hour for 0.6 hours. How long did she run then at 6 miles per hour? Well, she ran 1.1 minus 0.6, which is 0.5. So she ran for half an hour at 6 miles per hour, and she ran for 0.6 hours at 5 miles per hour. And the real tricky thing here is that piece where you have to remember to do this. And we're going to keep doing it. You're going to get pretty good at remembering that, but it's going to be weird at first. Okay. Third one, Don and Rose leave Bangor at the same time, headed in opposite directions. I didn't say in this they're riding on a bicycle, but they are. Okay. Don heads north at 3 miles per hour faster than Rose, who's going south. 2 hours later, they are 66 miles apart. How fast are they both riding? Can you see this picture? They're starting off here, and Don's going north, and Rose is going south. And after 2 hours, their total distance is 66 miles. Okay. So I know that Don's distance plus Rose's distance equals 66. Now, they both rode for 2 hours. They were both moving the whole time, so they both have a 2-hour time. What's their rate? Well, Don was going 3 miles per hour faster than Rose. So let's say that Rose's rate is X. I don't want to use R because R is rate, and rate could stand for both of them. If Rose's rate is X, what would Don's rate be? Well, he's going 3 miles per hour faster. That's not 3X, that's X plus 3, right? So Don is going X plus 3 rates, Rose is going X, and they're both traveling for 2 hours. So we have 2 times X plus 3 for Don, and we have 2 times X for Rose, and those things add up to be 66. And that is 2x plus 6 plus 2x equals 60. 4x, that's 66. I don't know where, I keep jumping ahead. 4x equals 60 when I subtract 6 from both sides. And dividing both sides by 4, I get x equals 15. Whoops, x equals 15. Now, who is riding at 15 miles per hour. It's whoever we said was X, which was Rose. So Rose is cycling at 15 miles per hour, and Don is going 3 miles per hour faster. So he's going 18 miles per hour, because we would take Rose's time and we would add 3 to that to get to Don's, because we're saying he's going faster. So those are 3 different types of word problems that all have to do with distance, rate, and time. And I believe the one in the middle is going to be the one that you find to be the most difficult. You just have to keep practicing. You'll get this whole idea down. This idea right here is a thing that people spend a little time thinking about. All right, have a fantastic time, and we will see you next time.